prizes went to Johan Flock, who grabbed the first two, 17444, and dial that number to stand in line to win some great prizes with the Dakar Rally. As I said, the guys are at sea today, all at sea, and they're going to be starting once again tomorrow live when we go through to Tunisia. Three stages there, five stages over in Libya where it's going to be really hot in the desert, and then six stages in Egypt as well. So some great action coming up over the next couple of weeks here on the Dakar Rally. Stay close for those prizes and the great competitions. Right now, let's go and join the action.
The next stage in Tunisia is only a 25 kilometer special, but still a long day, you know, 500 kilometers down to the bottom. And yeah, I want to just get into Tunisia now, settle down and get the real bivouacs going, and you know, not living out of trucks and running into hotels at 2 o'clock in the morning, you know. So yeah, let's get on with the race. It's been really great so far. The weather's been incredible. I mean, for a sunshine boy like me, you know, leaving home at 35 degrees and coming here, it's not so good to start in Paris in that freezing cold, and really it's been acceptable this year. We've been very lucky.
All under control. Must feel good though to be high up the order.
Yeah, I think it is important obviously to be up there, but the rally hasn't started yet really, so I mean, it's still a long way to go, and in Africa it will really start, but it's good to be up there, so at least you're within striking distance.
You know what, I work until 4 o'clock this morning. I was very lucky to borrow another engine from somebody.
Yeah.
Because the gearbox was completely destroyed. So I got another engine. It's, you know, it's an old engine, so I must just take it very easy.
The Dakar continues, 2003. No competitive stage mileage today because everybody is on a boat. They're crossing the Mediterranean. However, the rest of the Dakar caravan has jumped over into Africa. And have we got some highlights from the last 24 Dakars for you, all the way back to 1979. Now, these are pictures from the 8 kilometer stage in Spain yesterday at the town of Castellón, right on the beachfront. The trucks were piling through. Whilst all the trucks found it easy going through the deep water as the tide had come in, the Dutch Jaguar, as you can see, had a rather more difficult time getting through the water. Frans van Engelen and Joris Pauvliet had some water in their 4.2 pushrod V8s, the Jaguar chassis over the top of a Range Rover base. And as you can see, those brand new Sparcos were getting dirty right from the very beginning. One of the local 4x4s was pulled in to try and get them out of the water, but not before another competitor came powering through, getting them even more wet. Once the car got moving. They tried to bump start it, but as you can see, he was having none of it. He says, we've got some water in the engine because it was a little deeper than we expected through the water splash, so we should have gone a little slower, but the water is out now and we're ready to go on. The 4.2 sounding back on glorious form. The Jaguar continues in the Dakar. So no specific stage today because everybody left on the boat over the Mediterranean very late last night from the town of Valencia before they dock very early tomorrow morning into Tunis. So looking back at sunset last night, the motorcycles of course were first onto the boats with Dakar boss Hubert Auriol overlooking, and of course Hubert's lucky number 100 being taken by Britain's Patsy Quick this year. Just as a reminder, first overall in the motorcycle section is Richard Sanks with his time of yesterday. Second overall is South Africa's Alfie Cox, and third overall Cyril Depre. Stefan Orard though in the car section saying, on the boat we're going to get some sleep because we worked very hard before the rally and now we have some problems with the cars, so these two nights are very important for us to get some rest. Onrad had some problems with his brakes, remember, at the Corbière stage, whilst Fabrizio Mioni on the big KTM V-twin went off to find his bed for a couple of nights. An enormous Spanish crowd was out, however, to watch Stefan Pedersen, the overall leader of the car section. And even Pedersen had time to tuck into the enormous paella together with Nissan's Kenjiro Shinazuka. Pedersen and Alfie Cox and Richard Sanks and Mioni all got stuck in together with all of the Dakar competitors. They ate nearly all of it. Goodbye to Valencia, and Africa was coming soon. And into Tunisia, the rest of the Dakar caravan had already arrived at Tozeur, and everybody was preparing for their first night under canvas. So a quick look back at all of the Dakars. Back to 1979 first with Thierry Sabine. Concerning the difficulty of the rally, I've brought you here, it's my choice, but as for the rest, well, that's just the rally. For example, in a sailing race, when the yachts get hit by a big wave, no one complains to the organisers, that's life. Tomorrow we'll be back on the road. That's the law of the Dakar.
C'est la loi du Dakar.
He drives at 110 miles an hour and terrorizes the whole desert. It's very, very hard, and the bike is heavy in the sand. The front is always sinking into the sand. There you go. I've already won a few bottles of champagne from a friend. In fact, I've probably got a few cases now.
Technology.
A crowded stage, it looks more like holiday traffic returning home on the motorway. What is it?
Deux chevaux, peut-être.
He says it's a 2CV. The last stages are very hard as exhaustion starts to blur your vision. You have to be careful, otherwise you'll fall. I was sleeping, he says.
Amour, amour, my love. La course autour dans les déserts, c'est comme une danse.
Pourquoi tu as pas suivi?
Why didn't you follow him? He asks. I thought I found Lele. Lele was behind me. It's not Lele you should have followed, but Petter Hansel. He's first and you're second.
Tu es deuxième. C'est une connerie là.
Your hair about. At dawn, we found four exhausted but determined men ready to go all the way on this journey.
Et à mener jusqu'au bout leur quête d'absolu, seul sur le tracé initial.
We got stuck more than 200 times, and each time we had to dig ourselves out. It was crazy. '98 saw Fabrizio Mioni annoyed with his GPS as it was not working properly.
Merda! No, ne pas.
However, it was much to the delight of the locals.
GPS, c'est du merda. Due GPS.
Oh là là, les pièces. Mais le soleil, jamais, je ne parle pas.
Gregor Demavius short of fuel and asking Jordi Arcarons. 25 litres? Can you give me 10? He asks. With 30 kilometres from the finish.
30 kilometres de l'arrivée.
Tu vas me donner ça, c'est plein ça.
And the co-driver saying, it's full.
Pas tout le réservoir, si?
Si, si.
Grégoire asking, can we take it all?
Merci, hein, je te vois tout à
l'heure. And the co-driver saying, we can't take everything.
Ah, carrément.
I'll pay you back though, says Grégoire. I'll pay you back. The Titanic battle between Neveu and Auriol came down to the last proper stage in 87. Neveu waiting for Auriol, but when Auriol arrived,
le jour sera la veille de l'arrivée.
He discovered he'd broken both his ankles with an enormous crash earlier.
I have worked 2.5 years. I have built the whole thing, and now it's finished.
2,000 hours.
It's finished. I am broken.
'92 saw crowd control in the villages being done by the locals.
You
feel like a grain of sand here. It teaches you humility as we're all in it together.
Et c'est vrai pour tout le monde ici. Il y a pas de vedette, il y a personne, et tout le monde vit au même rythme. C'est pour ça qu'il y a une belle ambiance.
Jean Baird doesn't need to take care of his bike, but his appetite as well. He brought some cheese and even some smoked ham to keep his spirits up.
Un bon gastronome dans sa sacoche deux fromages, un Cantal et un fromage de brebis corse. Ajoutez à cela un peu de viande séchée des grisons.
If you want to eat.
Ah,
eat and tea and coffee.
Tea, okay.
Tea, okay.
Stages. This car saying they're getting crazy behind us, but I'm not going to get out of their way. There were 602 competitors at the start, and here on the second stage, 75 bikes and 106 cars are out already. We've never seen this before. Never seen that before either.
Ah,
Puta Divina.
Lucky but to see it.
You are going so fast. Do you know the beauty of the desert? Inhabited by nomads, proud of their life. Going with the caravan along the dunes placed here by nature, you go so fast. Do you know the joy of the African children who are smiling along the road? The Rothmans Porsches had all that money and all that technology, but still got stuck in the mud. They may have won Le Mans more times than anybody else, but the Dakar catches everybody out. Is that the way to the finish? 8 kilometers away? Now we have time.
Vamos pra frente, é Brasil aqui no Dakar, é a CDI Competições do Dakar, é o Luizão Azevedo no Dakar.
Schlesser brought two-wheel drive technology in amongst the four-wheel drives. When someone else falls, you don't have the strength to help in. The team spirit just decreases away with your own energy. Thanks to the route he took, X is now up to 7th overall. But he'll always remember this passing of the Niger. I think it's the hardest route we've ever done on this rally. Any rally? Yes, any rally.
De loin le plus difficile.
Ça va?
Yes, I'm okay, but if I say that I'm going to do it again, please stop me. 17 hours I've had. It's like doing Paris to Marseille on small lanes, standing up on the pegs at 30 miles an hour. We have to be crazy. Vatanen saying, are the brakes any good? And the local taxi driver saying, well, yeah, I had to disconnect the front ones though, so they're only on the rear, but I couldn't put any more on the front because I haven't got any more replacements. How'd you get by? Well, I get by. All that sand and even sea. Moving Dakar through the air.
Oh.
Jutta Kleinschmidt, the first lady driver to set a fastest stage time on the Dakar. Montanay saying, this is the 14th time I've been on this beach, and yet every time there is still so much emotion. The first time you come here, you just don't know whether or not you should laugh or cry. It's just magical.
It's much more difficult than I expected, to tell the truth. But I'm very happy to be here. You know, I don't fight for the position. I just want to fight with myself and with nature and to be at the end. A few days ago I thought that I have to drive here fast and to be first in my class. Today it doesn't matter. Nothing here is important, really. Only to be at the end of the day, at the end of the super stage, that's all.
God created the desert so that God could measure man's own limits. The Dakar over the years has seen everybody as a winner. The Dakar caravan arrives in Tunis early in the morning, and then they do an 89 kilometer road section before the super special of 25 kilometers, and then the long road section of 349 kilometers down to Tozieur. And then they will be arriving into the heart of Tunisia, where the rest of the Dakar entourage is waiting. Africa is about to get underway.